right now on 5 on Your Side at 10.
Area firefighters battling flames and the bitter cold.
Everything at the scene is covered in ice.
Tonight, their concerns the frigid weather will spark more fires.
Well, the best we could do for a high today, 2 degrees. In some spots, didn't even make it above zero. Where that stands record-wise for today overall and what we'll see for the rest of the week.
Plus, warming up. The winter blast not keeping Cardinals fans from coming face-to-face with their favorite boys of summer.
We start tonight in a weather alert as most of the St. Louis region remains under a wind chill warning. Good evening, I'm Mike Bush. It's dangerously cold outside. Temperatures barely got above zero today, and they're going to fall back below overnight. Let's get straight over to meteorologist Gary Frank with our frigid forecast.
Very, very cold. One of those things where we got to think about turning the faucets on, checking on friends and neighbors, pets, things of that nature. It's that type of cold. We run through it once in a while, but what are we expecting over the next few hours? Right now, you'll still see that light dusting of snow that we had yesterday. We've got probably another one on the way later on. Overall, though, our coldest high temperatures, we actually got up to 3 well after sunset. Not that we saw much of it. So it did notch up to 3 at a very brief moment. It was still the coldest high temperature we've ever seen on January 14th. Keep in mind, our average high is 40 degrees. Right now, we have gone back down at no surprise. There are still some spots like St. Charles at 3, but 0 in O'Fallon. It could be worse. You could be in Kirksville or Kansas City or Des Moines or Moline, where you're at 15 below. And that cold air's around, but it's that cold air coupled with just a little bit of a light wind with has us under a wind chill warning and a wind chill advisory. The differences are how cold it gets. Right now, there are some spots to the north where it feels like it's 15 to 20 below, others 10 to 15 below. That's really the threshold, which we'll discuss here shortly. Hour by hour, heading into the overnight hours, we'll see a mix of clouds, but temps are falling at 5 below or so. Still very cold Monday and Tuesday with a little more snow, and it's sort of milder. Just sort of. We'll talk about that and also the records that we still may set over the next couple of days.
And you can stay up to date on our latest Weather First forecast. Just text the word weather to 314-425-5355 and we'll send it to your phone. Right now, St. Louis County Police are looking for a man who shot and killed a woman at a Jennings liquor store. This happened around 6 tonight at New York Market and Liquor on Jennings Station Road. Police say the victim and a man got into a fight inside the store when he shot her. She was taken to a nearby hospital where she later died. The man ran off, but anyone with information is asked to call Crime Stoppers, the anonymous tip line. That's 866-371-TIPS. Tonight, 3 people are recovering and 1 person is in custody after violence on a Metrolink train. Police responded to the Sunon Metrolink station in Maplewood around 12:30 this afternoon. That's where officers found 1 person shot, another stabbed, and a 3rd person who had been cut. The victims were taken to the hospital. They are expected to recover. Police believe a fight led to the assaults. This incident caused delays at the Shrewsbury and Brentwood stations. All trains are running normally now. Tonight, a man and a family dog are safe after their Eureka home caught fire this afternoon. It was a very tough fire to fight for first responders due to the extreme cold and the terrain of the area. 5 on Your Side's Laura Barczewski takes us into the hills where they battled the blaze.
Just after 3 o'clock Sunday, Eureka Fire Department, along with several other departments, responded to a large house fire off of Tall Oaks Drive.
Upon arrival, the first in unit, they had fire through the roof. There was heavy damage to the house at this point.
It took 25 different trucks and other apparatus, along with roughly 75 firefighters and EMTs, to put this fire out over several hours. Eureka Assistant Chief Scott Barthelmess says it was difficult for several reasons.
First off, we had heavy fire load conditions there. Second reason is it's cold and it's very hard on our personnel as they operate, so we need additional personnel. And then the third thing is we're in a no water area, so all the water we're using is having to be shuttled in.
2 firefighters were injured in the process but got checked out and are doing okay now.
There's a lot of slip hazards and stuff like that. We've had several firefighters slip on the scene already. We do bring in the canteen, the St. Louis STL canteen that comes, first responder canteen that comes in and starts providing some nourishment. We use ambulances to put personnel in to warm them up.
They said only 1 person was home at the time with the family dog.
Animal control is here to help the animals so that they can get them somewhere for the evening as well, so that the animal doesn't suffer. But the animal's okay and the resident is okay.
Bartholomew says the house is heavily damaged, and while they don't know what started the fire, they want people to be very careful when it's this cold.
Make sure that you're using safe heating means, that you know, if you're using a fireplace that's been inspected, all those safety, those fire safety, things are right now are key.
Reporting in Eureka, Laura Barcheski, 5 on your side.
It's also been a tough and busy day for St. Louis firefighters. They battled several vacant home fires in the frigid conditions, like this one on Minnesota Avenue in South City. A fire captain there told our crew he expected more fires to come during this cold spell, and he was right. Another fire broke out hours later in North City. This time, it was at a vacant home on Whittier and Cote Brilliant. No injuries were reported, and no cause was given for either fire. As crews battle fires in frigid conditions, they want folks at home to know how to stay safe this winter. The National Fire Protection Association says home fires happen more in winter than any other season. A lot of it is because of space heaters at home, but those can turn deadly if they're left unchecked. Heating equipment is involved in one of every six reported home fires and one in every five home fire deaths.
Take a jacket off, we go to throw it, and it lands on there, and we forget about it, and that starts fires there. The other things that I need people to understand is that your gas stoves are not for heating.
Here's a few more things fire departments want you to know. If you're using your fireplace, make sure you burn dry wood. Also, keep your pipes warm and sprinkler systems active so they don't freeze up.
It's colder this year than I remember, for sure. But it's the same every year. Great, great fans, great players that come back.
The bitter cold didn't stop Cardinals fans from meeting their favorite Redbirds past and present. The Cardinals' annual winter warm-up is taking place during the coldest weekend of the winter season. Five on Your Side's Annie Krall met up with eager fans ready for baseball and baseball weather.
Fans from near and far have descended on Busch Stadium and Ballpark Village this weekend.
I grew up in Southern Illinois, and that was just our thing. They would listening to Jack Buck on the radio. It was a big event for us to get to come to one game a year to travel from Southern Illinois. My dad taught me how to keep score, and I just loved baseball, and it just seems to, my parents aren't here anymore, but it connects me to them. In a way.
Laura McCune adding to her jersey of 175 autographs, a piece of memorabilia she started 21 years ago, thanks to
Al Hrabowski. I was over at his bar across the street when he opened it, and he signed it, and that's when I started getting the signatures on it, and that was in, I think, 2002 or 2003.
Parents now helping the next generation find their favorite Redbird and Cardinals legend, like
Yadier Molina.
Why do you like Yadier so much?
Because I just like the way he plays and how good he is at catching.
Here at Busch Stadium and at Ballpark Village, fans are willing to risk it out here in the cold temperatures to see some of their favorite players. With pitching being so challenging last year with the Cardinals ranking 23rd in MLB, considering their 4.5 average ERA.
Endurance is huge, so there's been a lot of aerobic focus this offseason, conditioning focus, and then just regular, muscular endurance, making sure that I can go out and throw 100 pitches and maintain that velocity.
While I'm not talking about fastballs, some heaters were needed for one of the chilliest warm-ups in recent memory.
I wanted to wear this jacket, layers underneath, so I could take this off and put it in my bag. But to be honest with you, I haven't been able to take it off all day. It's been so cold.
Fans dreaming of warmer days at Busch Stadium. Reporting in St. Louis, Annie Krall, 5 on Your Side.
We're 81 days from the home opener at Busch. The winter warm-up wraps up tomorrow, and you can buy your admission and autograph session tickets on the Cardinals website. A trauma surgeon redefining doctor's care.
I want to put myself out of business.
How he's making a difference by healing lives impacted by gun violence. Big changes coming tomorrow for Metro buses. The promise to get riders where they need to go sooner.
Multiple areas of wind chill warnings and wind chill advisories in place through Tuesday by midday. And yes, that does seem to be the stopping point for our cold weather. How cold it gets between now and then, and what we'll see the rest of the week.
Coming up on Sports Plus, wait till you hear what Jordan Walker has done to his body in the offseason. We'll have that story. Plus, I sit down the World Series MVPs, David Freese and David Eckstein. And exactly who did David Freese hear from after his majestic performance in 2011?
Tyson hit me up on Twitter, DM me. Yeah, like a long,
Really?
Yeah, long message. We talked a little bit. Tyson.
Plus, Bradley Carnell from City SC stops by for a visit. And we will have some soccer players from the area trying to win a national title. See you in 20 minutes for Sports Plus.